work out?
Every workout's a good workout, man.
Steroids will do that to you, eh?
Steroids! I've never used them, and I never will. This is pure animal brute strength.
Right, you're right. Yeah, got it. No steroids, right.
Man, I need a raw egg shake. Nathan, are we out of eggs?
No way, man. I just got some from the market yesterday.
Not the one on 4th and Main, man!
Yeah, why?
That old man freaks me out. I read some weird stories about those eggs.
Years ago, I bought eggs from a market at the corner of 4th and Main. Little did I know the evil that lurked inside those eggs. When I got home, one of them hatched, and a giant cockroach came out and attacked me, and attached itself to my neck. I managed to get it off before its telekinetic powers overtook me, but in the process it ate my face. That's why I wear this mask. Ever since then, I've been aware of their psychic birth cries and their attempts to take over the world. Now we need to stop them before more people end up like your friend here, or worse.
What do you look like without your mask?
Take over the world!
I don't want to take over the world. I just want to eat people.
I can't let you do that either.
Then you'll have to stop me.
I will.
I'd like to see you try.
You will.
And come and get me.
Here I come.
You'll never stop me.
Oh, yes, I will.
This doesn't concern you, young man. Be gone with you!
Fuck you!
Fuck me?
But first, I'll have to kill you!
Ah!
Coming and there's nothing you can do about it.
There's one thing I can do about it.
To my work. Satan Slaughter 6, as with the other Satan Slaughter films, is more of an experience. And I am more than a filmmaker, I'm an experience maker.
Wait, tell us about your experience of Satan Slaughter 6.
Well, it's been generally a positive one, although I found some of the actors rather difficult to deal with. Especially certain ones who kept messing up their lines.
Excuse me while I go wash off your girly juices.
Womanly juices!
Womanly juices.
What the fuck is this? How am I gonna win an Academy Award if you keep fucking up my brilliant text? Cut! Cut! And what they don't realize is that the words that come out of their mouth, if I haven't written them, really have no meaning. Words only have meaning when a meaning is bestowed upon them by a meaning giver. Thus, I'm more than a filmmaker and an experience maker, but I am a meaning giver. I do use sex and violence in my films, but not to titillate, but to instruct.
What are you instructing us?
I'm instructing about sex and violence.
No, I can't throw it, it's just fall.
Action. Action.
Oh, shit.
In my work, I want it to be as if you were looking into a mirror when you look at this screen. And that when you look in that mirror, you would see yourself reflected back at yourself. But it is not yourself, but my artistic representation of yourself, thus making you more real than you could possibly be.
Action. Action.
Jeez.
Who did you commission to paint this painting?
Oh, I did it myself.
Oh, you're a painter as well.
No.
Action. So you painted that portrait of yourself. Did you do it in the mirror? Looking at yourself?
Yes.
Action.
Really, life is not about experience. What about the context? For example, the context of this interview would be quite out of context if it were not for the context that it is given.